In the criminal justice system, street racing offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Street Racing Prevention Unit. These are their stories.
Yeah, that's something else to have next to you, this freaking TRX. It's huge. And he's got the Ram bar. That's my favorite part. Goddamn thing is compared to this fucking Cadillac and compared to this Honda Accord. These things are freaking monstrous. Uh-oh, we got the Ram 2500. Man, it's a big-ass trucks, man. Jesus Christ. It's like, how dare you put things like that on public roads? Big ass trucks. Look at these things. It's like monstrosities. What? Do you wanna use that turn signal or what? What the hell is going on here? I gotta get from behind you. There's something wrong with your ass. He's got the original electric Cadillac. He's got the ELR, but that's basically like a Chevy Volt with two doors. It's a Cadillac screwed that car up. Instead of making that car like a usable four-door sedan, he turned it into a two-door coupe, and nobody really bought it. Except this guy. Uh-oh, the trucks, they got a truck race. Monster truck rally. Oh, shit, I can't get there because this fucking guy. Look at this guy. Oh, my God. You stupid guy in the fucking Camry. This guy. Messed everything up. I was trying to catch up to the monster trucks. I said, come on. You know what? I guess I gotta kind of just give up because there's no way. Unless we get stuck in heavy traffic, there's like no way I can catch up to them. Look at these people. It's like you're trying to box me in or something. Eh, whatever. I still see them. They're like right there. I got the two monster trucks. We got the monster truck rally. It's like Sunday. Whoa, shit. Freaking pebbles. Gotta get behind this bus. What the hell? Yeah, those monster trucks are moving, boy. I barely see them now. Yeah, I think they're gone. I give up. Yeah, wait, no, I still see them. They're down there. They're still jousting for positions. Yeah, oh well. I'll catch them up later. It's a nice day out here. Thank God it's Friday. And there's not much traffic on my way to Manhattan. And the reason why is because I think people are still working from home. A lot of those offices have not reopened. So, you know, it is what it is. You know, people still working from home. I'm amazed because if I was their boss, I'd have been like, nah, get your ass back here. Look at the Porsche dealer. This is what happens when the interest rates are so high. It's like they can't suddenly sell certain cars, right? Look at the cars they got sitting there. So you got an Acura NSX, you got some Taycans, you got a fucking Aventador sitting next to a Urus, and then you got the, Bentley I think that's a Bentley Speed, if I'm not mistaken. I gotta see the... Yeah, wait, no. I think that's a Bentley Speed model. It's definitely Continental GT, but I... No, I don't think that's a Speed model. Yeah, but they can't sell this shit. Not right now, anyway. Interest rate's high as fuck. They usually have Rolls Royces sitting out here, and then, you know, they have the regular Porsches right there. The interest rates are so high. It's like, this shit ain't moving. Yeah, I think that's... Fuck, I think that's hilarious.
Daughter to go see the Little Mermaid in Orlando, and this happened.
Oh, I need a refund on my ticket. No, we getting a refund because No. We need a refund.
What's going on?
This is a kid's movie. Oh my God.
You got a woman driving the TRX with her son. Look at this big TRX. Got this little lady handling the TRX. Look at that. That's amazing. That is one big truck. She's sitting on 707 horsepower. She's probably going to the same place I'm going. I gotta go to the gas station. Yeah, yeah. Get out of her way. She's driving a TRX. Get out of her way. Hell's wrong with y'all. Yeah, let's see what gas prices look like under Joe Biden for Memorial Day 2023. Oh, shit. Look at that line. Oh, look at this line right here. Is that a line? Let's see what the gas station... What is this? 320, 335? What is premium? What is that? What's premium? This sucks. Well, my thing is, it's like, y'all shouldn't complain. Y'all voted for Biden. So when you get drowned by illegal aliens, you get drowned in gas prices, and you get evicted and shit because you couldn't afford anything because you lost your job, don't complain. You deserved it. You voted for it. And so I don't want to hear no complaints. I don't want to hear no complaints at all. I don't want to hear no complaints. You voted for it, you got it. You got it. What is this? $389 for fucking premium. Look at that. $389. Y'all voted for it, you got what you deserved. So if you want to redeem yourself, then I suggest you vote better next time. So if Trump runs, you better support him, because otherwise you're going to be screwed. I don't even think, I don't really want DeSantis, but if DeSantis is the only choice besides one of these filthy-ass Democrats, I'll vote DeSantis. I'll do it.
Oh, but he's trying to erase African-American studies.
It's like, listen, there's enough books out there. You got the motherfucking internet in the palm of your goddamn hands. If your kids were on the internet doing what they should be doing instead of watching motherfucking TikTok all goddamn day, then nobody could erase no African-American history. Because the thing about it is, the information's there. The question is, what are you doing? Are you wasting time? Or are you watching TikTok all goddamn day? And that's the sad thing. That's what I hate about these politicians. They won't tell you that shit to your face. I tell you. I'd stand right up there and I'd destroy my campaign by telling you, you know what? Maybe if your kids stop watching motherfucking TikTok, maybe they could learn some black history. In fact, I'll give you a second. I'll give you a middle ground. How about you make black history videos on TikTok and run that? And this way, nobody could erase no black history. But I'll tell you this. I don't want to vote for DeSantis. You see, I don't believe in Diet Coke. If I'm going to get Coca-Cola, I want the real Coca-Cola. Trump is the real Coca-Cola. DeSantis is motherfucking Diet Coke with lemon. And I'm not interested in Diet Coke with lemon. I don't want no Diet Coke with lemon. I want the real Coca-Cola. If you're going to fuck my arteries up and give me heart disease and shit, I want the real thing. Who is this guy? And why is this guy? Who is this? Oh, he's just going to the garbage can. Yeah. It's like, you got to watch out because there's like car thieves and shit around. It's like, you never know. It's like, I got to keep this Desert Eagle cocked. Because you never know. Somebody might try to take your SRT or something. I ain't having it. I'm not having it. And this lady got the A-spec Acura. Ugh. What a crappy car. All right. So let's go out there and pump some gas. I do these news stories called Pain at the Pump. You don't see those stories anymore, oddly enough. Why don't they do those stories called Pain at the Pump? It's true. Look at this person with the Scion. See, this person, even though this person has a Scion, she's feeling pain at the pump because pump is 335 because you got to use regular unleaded, just like this shitty. But then again, I think, well, that's an Infiniti right there, so I don't know what they use. I think they use premium. I'm not even sure. It doesn't really matter. Everybody's feeling pain at the pump. I don't like pain at the pump. 389. Look at this shit. So you got the Scion right here. She's cool. She's like, yeah, I got the hamster car from Kia and Scion before Scion went out of business. I got the original hamster car. You know, she's got cool glasses on. She's like, yeah, I'm about to spend $35 on gas. Oh, God, look at this shit. This is Memorial Day 2023. $3.89 a goddamn gallon. People be like, when are you getting your Cadillac? When are you getting your Cadillac? Listen, my Cadillac is coming. They have not built it yet. It is still being built. And as soon as they finish building my Cadillac, I will have my electric Cadillac. And my electric Cadillac, I will not have to come back to this goddamn gas pump ever again. You see, ladies, this is what happens when you don't have a man there to pump your gas and to put air in your tires. This is what happens, ladies. You got to get down there on your knees and all that. You got to do it yourself. See, they tried to tell, Kevin Samuels tried to tell you, but y'all didn't like him because he said mean things. Trump tried to help you, but you didn't like Trump because he said mean things. See, look at this. Look at the pain at the pump. If this was the Trump presidency, gas would have been like $2 right now. And I still think that's high. If I was president, I would open up trade with Venezuela and we would make gas at a dollar for premium. If I was, oh, look at that, F-18s. Oh shit, look at that. Wait. Those are F-16s. I think, yeah, those are F-16s. It's kind of hard to see them. They're either F-18s or F-16s. Holy shit. See, yeah, those are like F-16s or F-18s.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a surprise. That was definitely a surprise. I don't know if they, look at this. 81, look at this. 81.75. Let's see if we get $82 in there. Oh, there we go. Boom. All right. Okay. On their way to Dubai on the Emirates A380. Here's a change of scenery. So I'm out here next to the airport. That's my airport right there where I fly out of. If you're interested in doing ground or pilot school or IFR training, Farmingdale Airport, Farmingdale College right here. And some of the videos that I've made where I'm flying, this is exactly where I am because the training is right there. The Farmingdale Aerospace College, and then over there is the Air Power Museum. So I'm here shopping for flowers right now. Uh-oh, he getting ready to take off. I could stay here and do this shit all day. I could just get a beach chair and just sit next to the fence. I could get a beach chair, sit next to the fence. I could do this shit all fucking day. And by the way, if you're interested in flying, somebody did ask me that question, and I've put a couple of people on to Nassau Flyers for one. But if you are interested, just send me a message and I'll get right back to you because, we usually have deals for pilot training. We have deals, usually there's like a sale, especially if you pass the pilot exam and everything. And you can rent jets and you can also rent aircraft from Nassau Flyers. All day, but yeah, so a couple of people have asked me about it. Personally, American pilots, you always hear about strikes and everything. American pilots don't make what they want to make for the hours that they work, and on top of that, like the aerospace engineers, they make all the money, but the mechanics don't get paid like they want to get paid, So it all depends where you are. Like if you work in the middle of nowhere at an airfield that is necessary to national security, maybe you'll make some money there because they're just trying to keep you there. But you probably end up with what feels like a dead end job. So you got to be careful with that. But piloting, it has its benefits. Yeah. So I'm up here looking. See, this is the thing. See, when it comes to flowers, it's like, if I see nice flowers, it's like, yeah, I'll buy them. But for the most part, I buy perennials because this way they're very low maintenance. My gardens come up every year right on time. All it has to do is rain real heavy in the parts of the spring. And all you got to do is just plant these things. They just keep coming back, makes it easy. So I hadn't seen a whole lot that really caught my eye. I did pick out a couple, and we'll probably plant them tomorrow. Then again, it's still sunlight, so I could do it today, but who knows. Yep, and let me tell you about that NVIDIA stock. You see over after hours, you see Micron, AMD, these things are climbing. And I tried telling, what's so fucked up? It's funny because right now there's a lot of people calling into the brokerage and they're like, yeah, put me in NVIDIA. And the problem is they're late. So they're not going to make the money that I made. And then the other ones are like, yeah, find me the next NVIDIA. It's like, yeah, stupid. I already found you the next NVIDIA. I told you about Micron. I told you about AMD. It's like, you just because you're late. You're late to the party. It's like, you got to be careful. You can't be late to the party. Yeah, always late to the party. If you're going to be late to the party, it's like, you might as well just keep your money. If you're going to be late to the party. If you're going to be late to the party, you might as well just keep your money. It is what it is. So, these are nice. It's like if you had, you could plant an entire, I hear a Tesla somewhere. Yeah, there's a Tesla Model S. It's got that weird sound. Yeah, these are nice. I don't know how much these are. These don't look like perennials. These are annuals over here. Yep. A good old Cessna Skyhawk. 2 for $20. Yeah, but these are annuals. I don't want that. Yeah. I think so far, the most expensive one I hear picked out here was this one. And this is it's almost like three different plants in one, actually.
some over here. I don't know what those are. I just want my gardens to look nice. You know? It's like if you come here, a couple $100, and you're just going to spend it all on flowers, you could make your garden look real nice. That's the thing, man. These dividend stocks. Like, see, my thing is, I'm holding NVIDIA because NVIDIA, I believe, first of all, right now, their market cap's like $900 million. It's like they're going to a trillion. And I'm looking at some of these people all of a sudden now. Oh, yeah, well, don't rush into it. It's like, listen, if you buy it now, yeah, you're buying it overpriced. But the thing about it is NVIDIA is still going to a trillion. So maybe it'll go to $500 a share. Maybe it'll go to $450 a share, whatever it is. The bottom line is I'm holding. I am so glad that I got in to that stock split. 4-for-1 for every single share you had. They gave you 4 shares. You know, I tried to tell everybody, but some people, no, I want to buy Bitcoin. We're going to the moon. We're going to Pluto. We're going to Jupiter. That's what they said. And by God, it looks like they never got there. How unfortunate for them. I tried to tell them. I tried. You heard me try. They just didn't listen. And it's funny because every single one of my crypto haters who doesn't like my channel because I talk down on crypto, every single one of them has dried up. Like, I'm starting to miss them. I'm starting to feel lonely. It's like, what happened to the guys that would attack me when I, oh, you don't know what you're talking about. We're going to the moon. You know, what happened to those guys? What happened to all my GameStop? What happened to all the guys who, oh yeah, no, you don't know what you're talking about. This is a gamma squeeze. Don't you know what a gamma squeeze is? Gamma squeeze means that you take the gamma and you multiply the alpha and then you get the beta. And then, and I'm like, you stupid asshole, just shut up. And I tried telling these people, but they lost so much money. What happens if you're doing your due diligence and you're trying to tell these people, but they just don't listen? I don't get it. They don't listen. Betting plants are 8-for-20. Yeah, but these, I don't know. Maybe after I get it. Maybe I will. Come on, man. You're in a parking lot. Nobody want to hear that piece of shit out of you with that slow ass twin turbo bullshit. Fucking 6-4, whatever the hell it is. Nobody cares. Out of you. Yeah. Yeah, I tried to tell them, but they just didn't listen. Just take a very, very, very quick look at the market. First of all, the Dow Jones is still down from where it was before the Russia-Ukraine invasion, right? So if you really look, the tip of the Dow Jones was about 36,799 points. And we're right now 3,000 points below that. We never actually made 37, but I think eventually 37 is coming. And I think that rally is going to be led by the mega cap tech stocks for the most part. Because if you've noticed, the tech stocks have all pretty much, they're not exactly at their peak, but they've regained most of what they've lost ever since the Russia versus Ukraine war. And that was a major turning point because you got to remember, there's like 144 million Russians. And then on top of that, China decided that they were going to go into COVID lockdown right around that exact same time. So the market took a tremendous hit because here you lost a lot of potential buyers out of the market, right? So it's coming back, obviously. But as you can see, these tech stocks are basically leading the pack. Now, I want you to notice, right now, and I've been noticing this a lot because I've been listening to a lot of opinions about NVIDIA, and I've seen a lot of people basically sounding the alarm. While I agree with them that right now is probably not the best time to be buying NVIDIA because the stock price is already so high, within the last couple of months, the stock price has risen considerably. So while I do agree with them with that, that you'd be buying at a market peak, where I disagree with them is how far they think it'll go. If you look at NVIDIA, It's $963.2 billion. NVIDIA is most likely going to be the next trillion-dollar company. And it will only take a short swing of the market to push them into the trillion-dollar mark. And basically, with all of these mega-cap tech stocks, they all basically want to go to $1 trillion. I mean, you look at Microsoft. Apple was the first to hit $1 trillion, and then Apple was the first to hit $3 trillion. Microsoft followed right behind them. Microsoft hit $1 trillion, and then Microsoft hit $2 trillion. And this was all after Apple, because Apple was the first to pull it off. And then you see Google. Google followed behind. They did their stock split. They got enough investment in, and then they're $1 trillion. Actually, it's $1.58 trillion. Amazon did the same thing, $1.23 trillion. They did their stock split about the exact same time that Google did their split. And it was funny because ever since I saw Apple do it, and then I saw other companies start to do it, like NVIDIA followed, NVIDIA and Tesla followed Apple. And then I realized, I was like, wait a minute. All of these companies are doing the same shit because they know that a stock split is the best way that they can get people to actively invest into the companies. So now these companies are sitting around with $1 trillion in their market. And, you know, it is what it is. But if you got in, you know, you should have made bank. If you didn't get in, then you're probably, I don't know, maybe you had a better idea. Maybe you invested in Bitcoin or something and you lost a lot of money, I guess. I don't know. So, yeah, the cryptocurrencies are still where they are. Bitcoin's still 27,000. It kept flirting, constantly flirting with 30,000, but just never quite getting there. But I don't want to talk about that right now. It's a waste of time. I was telling y'all about this Micron. I was telling y'all about this Micron. Micron, AMD, TS, Taiwan Semiconductors, TMC, they all got pulled up behind NVIDIA because of this AI craze. I was telling y'all about this Micron. I've been telling y'all about Micron. I did the video about a month ago, Bet on Chips. Video's still there. I don't erase anything. There's no point. Because somebody could always call you out if you erased it. Nah, but you know what? I've been consistently right. That's the crazy thing about it. These chips, forget the AI for a second. These chips, you got to understand, NVIDIA, Micron, AMD, these people are going to be making chips for everything. They're going to be making chips for your car. They're going to be making chips for your electric stove, your dryer. They're going to be making chips for your refrigerator. You got to understand, these semiconductor chips go in everything, your television, your everything. Like it's crazy when I say everything, because I mean, even your electric sockets are smart sockets now, and they got chips in them where you could be out in your driveway and you turn off your air conditioner from the driveway inside the house. It's like crazy. It's crazy. They got chips in every goddamn thing. Your ceiling fans got fucking chips in it. Your headphones got chips in it. Your everything. I can't even think of anything that doesn't have chips in it. It's like they put smart chips in every goddamn thing. So eventually everything gonna have some chips in it. So it doesn't even matter who you buy into. It really doesn't matter. Everybody who's making this goddamn semiconductor chips, it's all about the chips. I've been saying this. Well, I can't say nobody's listening because YouTube, they've suppressed information. So for the most part, it's really that nobody's hearing the message. But it's like I'm screaming and I'm trying to get the word out so y'all can get in on this money. But, you know, what else? What am I going to do? I can't fight the system, right? But, yeah, that's just where it is. Tesla is always prone to wild swings, so don't be surprised if because, you know, Tesla just recently announced the Cybertruck. They have this horrible-looking interior in the Cybertruck, and rich people have conned themselves into believing that minimalist is better. I don't know what that's about. But for the most part, Tesla is making its way up. Tesla has these wild swings where, because of the options trading market, they'll gain hundreds of dollars right away, and then they'll lose it, like, a little bit later. It's just really crazy with Tesla. It's like a roller coaster. But who else? Yeah, TSM.
If you're looking to buy into the chip market, you can't afford NVIDIA. Need I tell you about Taiwan Semiconductors? Need I tell you? Look at the chart. Like I was trying to tell you all about this. I told you all about this months ago, even years ago, because I was telling you to get that NVIDIA stock split and AMD. Since, you know, see what it is AMD and NVIDIA are close rivals because they both make graphics cards for video gamers, right? And originally, NVIDIA and AMD originally shot up because of crypto mining. But crypto mining is dead now because cryptocurrency is dying. And for the most part, their stock values started to fall, especially when you had that Russia-Ukraine situation. And because, you know, Russia was a huge crypto miner. Like, they had a bunch of those crypto mining farms and stuff over there. But the thing about it is, NVIDIA and AMD, at the same time, both of these guys were rising. TSM was also rising. And so was Micron. And then they all plummeted due to the, you know, the market problems, especially with the war. But the thing about it is, we're back. And this time, there's no telling how high these things is going to go. There's just no telling. Now, bottom line is, either you're in or you're not. Now, AMD doesn't pay a dividend. TSM does pay a 1.3% dividend. And as you can see, NVIDIA does pay a 0.04% dividend per share. So while their dividend per share is not extremely high, you know, holding on to the stock, you never know. They may change the amount of dividend that they plan on paying, because I believe TSM recently increased their dividend. And AMD, I don't know if they will. Because see, and this is another thing you got to understand. When you're buying dividend-paying stocks and you're also buying it to certain companies, sometimes there's companies that pay no dividend and they decide to offer a dividend. Like, for instance, when I bought into Ford, Ford was paying a dividend. Then they stopped paying a dividend. And then later on, they brought the dividend back at 2%. GM, for example, they're paying a dividend too, despite the fact their stock price dropped from 60 to 30. Right now, I also recommend that GM is a strong buy right now. GM, because see, GM was at like 60-something dollars, but now, as you can see, what is it? GM was recently, what was it, within the last 2 years. And see, the problem is you have to go back 2 years because you got to take into account this Russia-Ukraine shit. But the thing you have to understand is right now GM is actually a strong buy. But sometimes you got to remember, when it comes to dividend stocks, there are some companies that pay a dividend and then stop paying a dividend. But then there's other companies who aren't paying a dividend that start paying a dividend. And then there's some companies that have a dividend and they increase or decrease it based upon the profits. Now, somebody had asked me about talking about bank stocks and oil stocks. Now, I'd done that for a while because that was where I started making a lot of money in the oil stocks. But the thing about these banks and oil, and as you know, I grouped them together because basically, you know, when I would talk about one, I'd talk about the other. Oil stocks are being manipulated by the federal government. And that's just the simple way of saying it. Oil stocks are being manipulated. If it wasn't for the manipulation of the U.S. government and the sanctions that we've put on Russia and Venezuela, for example, gas prices would be super low. You'd be able to gas up your car for $1 a gallon, super premium, unleaded 93. You'd be able to fill up that oil tank on your house for like maybe $200 or $300. But they're manipulating the goddamn fuel prices. So because they're manipulating it, the oil stock market just isn't what it was when oil went negative. Now, I don't foresee oil going negative anytime soon ever again. The only thing that brought oil negative was COVID. And COVID basically forcing the planes to stay grounded, forcing people to stay in their house. That basically made it so that these stocks went negative. I don't think that's happening again. The only thing that would cause that to happen at this point, in my opinion, is like nuclear war or some shit. But I don't foresee that happening, and hopefully it doesn't happen. But anything could happen on any given Sunday. So I don't foresee oil going negative again. So if you didn't buy into oil when I told you to, well, I don't think at this point that you're going to be able to afford to get into them, because now they're so expensive per share, unless you're the type of person who literally has like $10,000 or $5,000 and you're willing to diversify and you're willing to buy like maybe $1,000 per company and take out as many shares as you can buy with $1,000 per company. Because the way I see it, if you're not putting in at least $1,000 to the oil or the banks, keep in mind these are dividend paying stocks. If you're not doing at least $1,000, then you're really not serious. Now, I don't want to sound like one of those brokers who's like, oh, yeah, well, you know, if you're not buying 10,000 or 20,000 shares of this penny stock, you're not serious. But I feel that that's how I sound. I don't want to sound that way, but the point is, just looking at how much I get paid in dividends, I realize that had I not put so much money in, I wouldn't be getting a significant amount of money back with them holding the money that I put in. So $1,000 goes a long way. And $1,000, I mean, yeah, it's a lot of money for some people. I understand that. Tax season, it gets a little bit easier. Some people get large tax returns. But for some of these companies, it's like if you don't have like $1,000 minimum in, it's like you're just not serious. So that's just how I feel about it. Like some people might criticize me. They'd be like, oh, you're an elitist or some shit. I don't give a fuck. But I'm just saying, in order to really get these dividends, you've got to own a lot of shares. Like you've got to own maybe a couple hundred shares in certain companies. That's the way I see it. It also depends on the dividend per share, but you know, that's just what it is. Now, as far as the banks pay dividends too. And think about it. Like if you invest $1,000 into JP Morgan, right? That would give you about 8 shares, give or take. And JP Morgan, what is this? They pay a dividend of 2.92%. So $1,000 invested into a bank in that, you know, it's not too bad. You know, Citibank is the same thing. Capital One is a little bit cheaper. So if you put $1,000 into Capital One, you're buying about 9 point something shares. But for the most part, let's say you bought 9 shares Capital One. I always try to buy in groups of 10, but yeah, what is that? $1,020, you could buy about 10 shares of Capital One, and they pay a 2.3% dividend. And the thing about it is Capital One, just like all the rest of the banks, they're down now, but they're coming right back up. Wells Fargo was at a high of like 56, and then we started having banking issues. All of the banks pay dividends. There's not really a lot to talk about. I would just say go after the really, really large banks, the banks that are too big to fail. JP Morgan is one. Citigroup is another. Capital One is another. Wells Fargo is another. Because I'll tell you this, with all the shit that Wells Fargo's been in, like getting caught making fake accounts, and they've been sued for discrimination. In fact, right now, New York is suing... Or they're saying that they're going to refuse to put deposits into Capital One or something because they claim that people are being discriminated against, which I think is bullshit. Because keep in mind, Capital One is my major bank. That I do most of my banking with Capital One. And I'm a black male. I'm 41 years old. I have an 850 credit score. There's nothing that Capital One offers that I can't walk in there and get. So if you're telling me that they're discriminating against you because you fucked up your credit score with Sprint or T-Mobile, that ain't my problem. And as far as I'm concerned, the bank doesn't care about your color. They only care about your history. If you're out there wasting credit card money buying jewelry and Air Jordans and stupid shit, then you deserve not to be able to get loans. And furthermore, my question is, who the hell is getting a loan right now for a house? When you're talking about a 7% interest rate on a house that's most likely more than $500,000, simply because the interest rates and the housing prices are inflated. Like, who the hell is getting a home loan right now? It's just like even asking for a car loan. Who's going after a car loan at 7%? Like, you're going to end up with a Toyota Corolla that you're paying like $800 a month for. It's crazy. Because these interest rates are so high that these things, they double the monthly payment of whatever you're trying to buy. Here's the kicker, though. Capital One didn't do that. Federal Reserve did that. So you should be talking to Jerome Powell and say, yeah, I'm a minority. You're discriminating against me. I'm a hardworking single mom, and you're discriminating against me. I'm a hardworking black single mom. I'm a hardworking minority. I'm a hardworking Hispanic American. Why don't y'all go tell that bullshit to Federal Reserve? I have a better idea. Instead of you blaming other people, why don't you, first of all, stop voting Democrat? That might help. And then on top of that, what else? I don't know. Petition the Federal Reserve to lower interest rates, but that's not going to help because they don't, you know, they're unelected. I don't know how the fuck these people get in office. They're unelected. I didn't elect nobody. I did not elect Jerome Powell. But even if I did, it wouldn't really matter. The national debt's $32 trillion almost. So they have to raise interest rates to a point where it curbs inflation. However, they can't raise them so high that they can't afford to pay the national debt because otherwise we'd end up defaulting on our loans as a country. So bottom line is stop voting for Democrats. And number two, if you've got any complaints, why are you complaining to Capital One? Go to the Federal Reserve and complain to them. It's not Capital One who's fucking you over. It's the Federal Reserve. But see, y'all people don't know nothing about government, and yet you're allowed to vote. That's the problem right there. But anyway, I diverge. Yeah, BP, Shell, Chevron, Valero. Those are my companies. Those are my favorite companies. Valero, Citgo, especially, you know, those are my oil dividends. And all of them pay. Sunoco pays a lot. Like when I get paid from Sunoco, it's weird because I almost get 1-to-1 for almost every single share I have. I'm basically getting like $1 out of it, which is pretty good because they have like a 7.89% yield. That's not bad at all. That's not bad at all. And then there's Occidental Petroleum. That's Warren Buffett's purchase. That's his main, that's what he invested in, Occidental Petroleum. I don't know if I have that here. But yeah, that's basically the market, guys. It's like if you're buying banks or buying oil stock and you gotta understand, this isn't get rich overnight. That's not how this works. This is you're trying to save up money towards retirement. So you basically put money in there and you gotta let it ride. While it's riding, you're collecting dividends, so you're getting a little bit back every single quarter. And if you're diversified enough and your dividends pay you during different quarters, it's like you have a nonstop flow of dividends coming in. So, and that's all based on how many shares you own. So my only point is, you know, these things are worth investing in. I just feel oil stock just isn't what it used to be now that the government's manipulating it. So my thing is, it's like you're better off going after the banks. And God knows how long it'll be before the government goes after the banks and gets their hands in there. Because, you know, it's funny. A lot of people don't seem to understand the difference between communism and socialism. Like, basically, pure capitalism is basically when, you know, you have the ability to succeed or fail and there's no government intervention. But what we have is socialism. That's when the government dips their hands in there and the government is literally setting prices. But then the worst thing is communism, where the government basically comes in and takes control of everything. You know, we don't have communism, but the, you know, I believe it was Lenin or Marx, they said that the true goal of socialism is reaching communism eventually, I believe. Don't quote me. But, yeah, you know, it's like as soon as they start, as soon as the government puts their hands in something, even with cryptocurrency, as soon as they get in there and they start regulating, that shit is over. The ride is over. It's over. You can't make no money in it no more. And even if you do, you got to file a 1099-K to tell them about your crypto gains. Because if you don't, and they find out, oh, yeah, so you trading cryptocurrency, huh? I guess you thought that it was anonymous. Nah, it's not anonymous. We're in there. We're watching you. So if you don't file that 1099-K, and you might get pushed up into a higher tax bracket because of some crypto gains that you made on shitcoin, well, you know, the government's going to get you. And when they get you, they get you hard. I got friends who've been sued because they didn't pay their taxes. True story. I worked for a bank. We were doing home loans and mortgages and whatnot. And this was a while ago. This was back in like 2006, 2007. And I kept telling them, I was like, yo, listen, you know, aren't you going to pay your taxes? It's like, how much are you setting aside for your taxes? Let me tell you something. My friends totally ignored everything I was saying. But see, me, I watched Cops and Real Stories on the Highway Patrol long enough to understand that when the government decides to come after you, it's like you're screwed. So I was like, you know what? Let's make sure I pay my taxes on time because these bastards are just going to come after me, right? So I tried to tell everybody else that. They were getting these personal checks, $10,000, $15,000. They were getting these personal checks based on commission. Some of y'all have worked in the industry, so you know that, you know, that's actually a low amount, $10,000, $15,000 of commission. You close three or four home loans and you get a big-ass commission check. Well, the bosses of my company, they were paying these dudes with personal checks. So the first thing in my mind is like, wait a minute. If y'all getting paid with personal checks, then there's no tax withholding. That's why me personally, I actually prefer W-2. I like W-2 and I like 1099 EZ. But I tried to tell these idiots, I'm like, yo, guys, you got to pay your taxes. Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, we'd walk in, like when we would cash those checks, we'd walk into Bank of America. And when we walked into Bank of America and they cashed those checks, the manager's jumping up trying to offer us coffee. You got the two young chicks behind the teller and they're waiting on us. And the chicks looking at our checks. And you could tell, man, them chairs were getting wet up. And that it was just like that. Some of these dudes actually dated some of the bank tellers. But let me tell you something. The one thing I didn't see was tax withholding. And that scared me because I was like, wait a minute. If they're not withholding taxes, then sooner or later, the government's coming to get that tax money. And if y'all aren't paying, you're getting thrown into the booty house. So with crypto, you think all these little kids who are running the crypto market and mining crypto, you think these kids are filing their taxes? Do you really think so? You think some of these parents have no idea what their kids are doing? They got computers and shit running and they're mining Dogecoin and shit, and their parents have no idea what their kids are doing. What do you think's gonna happen when that knock on the door comes from the IRS? What do you think's gonna happen? Oh, I didn't know Jimmy was a crypto millionaire. But I didn't know. Next thing you know, who do you think they're slapping the cuffs on? They're not slapping the cuffs on little Jimmy. They're slapping the cuffs on his parents. And that, well, you know, the IRS isn't going to lock you up, but they're going to hand you a bill. And all you got to do is pay the bill. But they're not going to lock you up, like, right away. Like, if they give you a bill and you don't pay it, then they're going to lock your ass up. But, I mean, it's just crazy, man. Once the government put their hands in it, it goes straight to shit. That's what Ronald Reagan said. He says the scariest words are where the government, we're here to help. Scariest words. He was right. So, you know, it is what it is. But again, if you want banks and oil, this is the best possible time to buy banks. If you want oil and you've got extra money, okay, yeah, you could go after the big oil. Like you go after Sunoco, Texaco, Amoco, Exxon, Occidental, Shell. You know, those are the ones you go after. Don't go after the little ones no more. Go after the big ones. Because if you go after the big ones, you get the dividends out of your money. So even if the value of the stock doesn't increase significantly, you're still collecting the dividends from it. And it's a very simple trading logic. I would say that I probably am a Warren Buffett style investor. I'm very risk adverse because, see, at the end of the day, I want to make sure I had the same amount of money that I had when I started. I just want a little bit more, which is why you get dividends. So I'm not trying to take risks. I'm not trying to bet the farm on motherfucking Dogecoin. I'm not trying to bet the farm on Ethereum. Oh, yeah, Ethereum is doing a merge. They're doing a hard fork. They're like, huh? What are you talking about? Yeah, well, you see how hard you got forked when your Ethereum holding went from 3,500 down to 1,900, right? You saw how hard you got forked. Your Ethereum forked you up. Your Ethereum forked you over. You got that hard fork. You got hard forked by Ethereum. You got hard forked by Bitcoin. Bitcoin forked you up. Bitcoin gave you the hard forking all night long. You got forked. You were watching your phone getting forked by Litecoin. You were getting forked by Bitcoin. You were getting forked by Ethereum. That's what you get for betting on the bad things. You should have bet on dividend paying stock, because I never got forked over by dividend paying stock. I don't believe in no hard fork. What are you talking about, hard forks? Y'all don't even understand what you're talking about. You hear this stuff, and then you repeat it like parrots. And that's why you're out of money. I bet Nayib Bukele in El Salvador, I bet he thought he was getting forked. He was like, yeah, I'm going to fork the whole world. Yeah. Uh-huh. He got forked pretty good when Bitcoin dropped from 55,000 down to 27. Yeah, he got forked. Yeah, he got the hard fork. That's what that two-year mark is, something else, ain't it? When you look at that two-year mark, that tells you all you need to know. And now the Federal Reserve has raised interest. What does it say? It says Bitcoin prices taper off as debt ceiling negotiations loom, huh? Yeah, right. So, yeah, but we're going to the moon. You don't know what you're talking about. You don't know anything about crypto. You're nothing but FOMO. You're full of FOMO. You don't know what you're talking about. We're going to the moon. Uh-huh. That's what they said. They don't look like they're on the moon to me. They don't look like they're on the moon yet. Those people who bought Ethereum at 3,500 and 4,500. I don't know. What is this? 48. So let me just think about this. Somewhere out there is somebody who bought Ethereum at $4,600 because they believed that it was going to $10,000. They were told, yeah, Ethereum's going to $10,000. Now, were there people who made gains? Absolutely, yes, there were. I've got family members who bought Ethereum at $50. Okay. There's nothing I could say there. Yes, you are up. You're very up. Congratulations, you're very, very up. The thing about it is, there's also a whole lot of people who bought Ethereum at $3,500. There's also a whole lot of people who bought it at $4,500. All of them lost their money. All of them lost their money. And the sad thing is, they were told that it was going to $10,000. They were told that they were going to double their money. Yeah, there's a fork coming up. You're going to get forked. You got forked, didn't you? Yeah, you got forked pretty good, didn't you? Got forked up. Ethereum forked you up. That's right. And then there's my favorite, XRP. Oh, my goodness. Whole lot of people lost a lot of money in XRP. A whole lot of businesses lost a lot of money in XRP. You know what's funny about XRP? At this point, I'm really, really anxious to see that lawsuit by the SEC. I'm really anxious to see it end. But every single time I look and check to see if it ended, it's like another 10 months goes by and nothing. Like, it's crazy, because even if you look at at the news, you're talking about like 24 weeks worth. Like, it was just, it looked like 25 weeks ago. That's 2 years. Coinbase delisted XRP, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum Classic, and Stellar. 25 weeks ago. And I'm waiting for the SEC. Look at this. SEC litigation. Ripple, Sol is selling, even despite there's people talking this stuff up. And that was 16 weeks ago. Nothing's happening. It's just crazy. It's just really crazy. Man, if I was wasting my money on this stuff, I'd be worried right now. Like, I'd be worried that I was never going to get my money back. Now, I do know that there's lots of drug dealers and money launderers out there who aren't worried about putting money into this stuff. I understand that. Yes, I understand that. But I couldn't do it, man. If I was a drug dealer or something, or if I was a nefarious individual, I'd be putting my money into Mangoat. Microsoft, Apple, NVIDIA, Google, AMD, Tesla. I'd be putting my money in those things. I just couldn't see putting my money in cryptocurrency and having some poor person in some third world country waiting to cash out my money. I couldn't do that. I just couldn't do that. But anyway, some people can, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, this market, you know, I have to give credit where it's due. I never imagined that Meta would come back as strong as it did, because I was really hoping that Meta would like go bankrupt. They went as low as $96, like, and I'm pretty sure once they got under $100, there's a lot of people who bet on Meta. But see, Facebook ain't what it used to be. They lost a lot of market share due to TikTok, and they lost even more due to Zuckerberg's ridiculous Meta, I'm gonna put virtual reality on everybody's heads, that nonsense. So, you know what, I have family who bought Meta, who when it was Facebook, and they've been holding it. So, you know, I really can't say anything about it. It doesn't pay a dividend, so that's one reason why. First of all, I hate Zuckerberg. That's number one. So I don't give a fuck if it goes to the moon. I'm not putting no money into it. I hate Zuckerberg. I'm part of a Facebook class action lawsuit. So I'm going to take some money out of Zuckerberg's pocket. We already got the money. It's just that once you join the lawsuit, they have to divvy it up amongst everybody who joined the lawsuit. But and we'll probably only get like $10 or $20. It'll be like a simple check for $10 or $20. But when I get that check, I'm going to frame it because I hate Zuckerberg that much. So I really don't care about his stock, and I'll never buy into it, ever. I would take that same amount of money and put it into Mangoat. I would never put that money into stock Facebook. Fuck Facebook. Because, you know, they don't believe in freedom of speech. And if they don't believe in freedom of speech, they are my sworn enemies. It's just that simple. There is no middle ground. It's war. So that it's just that simple. But I'm making big bank off of CTIC. I was telling you all about CTIC, this biopharma. I was telling you all about Sanofi and Gilead. Hopefully somebody bought into CTIC. I know I got a couple family members who did. In fact, if I'm not, for CTIC was like actually the first stock I ever bought. And that was back when I, when was that? That was when I had my first trading account. That was Scott Trade. CTIC was like the first, one of the first stocks I ever bought, but it was pretty much the one stock that made me open up my account. And CTIC has had a pretty decent run over the last 10 years. I was in there for that bull run that pushed it up to like 38. And, you know, they work with like blood cancer and leukemia and shit, and like injectables. So with biopharma, you just never know, because see, these companies are always inventing new things. And you think about it. If you were investing in Sanofi or Gilead, you had no idea that COVID was going to hit. And you also had no idea that COVID was going to push the stock prices up because of the sudden interest in getting vaccines. And that's the whole point. Viruses, vaccines, these things pop up all the time. And it's random. And you just don't know. So it's like, if you buy into these companies during peacetime, as soon as a virus or something comes out, all these companies shoot up. That's almost, I will say it like this, when they shoot up in value, that's pretty much when it's time to sell. Because if you sell then, chances are you'll make big bank. And then when the price settles again, you know, you can, you know, wash, rinse, repeat, you can buy some more. And you'll have walked away with big bank, you know. So it is what it is, but I'm making big bank. Like, my CTIC, man, I bought in when that shit was 80 cents. And it shot up to $9 within the last. Look at this. I bought it at 80 cents. I was telling y'all about CTIC at 80 cents. Think about that. 80 cents. And it shot up to $9. And yet you got somebody talking about Ethereum forking you? Really? You got a hard fork from Ethereum? We're going to take Ethereum and fork the hell out of it? What? What are y'all talking about? This is how I make my bank.
Yeah, that just lets you know right there how bad the economy is. It's like people can't even credit card this shit no more. And there's almost no resale value in these things either. So what is that? $1,649, $1,599. What is this? $1,699. Yeah, the 4080s aren't moving. because I think they're noticing that 16 gigabytes of VRAM is good, but the problem is everybody really wants 24. So the 4090s that have 24 gigs, those are doing pretty well, but they have a lot of these things. This is the, you know, they have the Supreme Liquid X back there somewhere, but they have a lot of these things in stock. I think they just don't keep the $2,000 ones on the shelf.
To be continued.